تحريم آلة الطرب, the prohibition of the musical instruments, refuting those who spoke about this hadith, and he refuted them a complete refutation, a beautiful refutation. So it is a must from you that you get this book, and it is a must from you that you read it, for verily he has refuted the ignoramuses, the ignorant ones, that speak from their ignorance and their evil desires in the affairs of religion, and they are not from his people. And then we ask the Shaykh Hafidhahu Allah Ta'ala about the issue of the hadith of laying on one's stomach, as there seems to be some difference of opinion amongst the scholars on whether or not that narration is authentic or unauthentic. And the Shaykh, he said, this hadith with me is hasan. I mean, this hadith to be hasan. And what is best for the Muslims is to stay away from this evil practice, and is not something, or like this, something that the people of honor, or like this would do, as this is from the activities of the people of Jahannam, or like this. And then I asked the Shaykh with regards to you bringing the hands back on the chest after ruku', as the ulama differ on whether you should put your hands to your side or put your hands to your chest. And the Shaykh said, I will say what Imam Ahmed said, that there in this affair there is room or space. And that if the individual sees after some reading that putting his hand on the chest is that which is correct, then he should do this. And if he sees that putting his hands to his side is correct without blindly following anyone, then this is what he should do from what is correct, from what he sees to be correct. And there is room in this affair, he says. And then we asked the Shaykh about the Taliban of Afghanistan, as we were wondering about their hal, their condition. And the Shaykh said they're from the Ikhwan al-Muslimin. And he said also at the end of the Kharafiyin, that they are not from the people who are from the correct understanding and methodology of the deen of al-Islam. And then we said to the Shaykh, we have opened a new markaz, a new center for learning, and we would like some nasiha from you. And then the Shaykh, he asked us, who are these people? I don't know these people. And we said, Shaykh, it is us, the Ikhwa, inshallah, from the Salafiyah here in the city of Philadelphia. And we would like to open this markaz. And the Shaykh said, I advise you to open only after you have united amongst yourselves upon the correct understanding. And I advise you not to be dividing and differing, and not to make differentiation between the Shaykh, the scholars. I advise you not to differentiate between the scholars, and divide amongst the scholars, and divide the scholars up. He says, be dividing between them from those who are in the East and those who are in the West. So verily all of them are brothers, and all of them are upon one manhaj. And you should have respect for all of them, no differing. But certainly differing is an hizbiyah, and it leads to evil and division. And beware of following the path of the hizbi, dividing the shayukh. But this is the plot of shaitan, to divide you. And respect the salafi manhaj, and respect its people in every time and every place. And I've heard that there is a fitna that is amongst you, that these have a shayukh and those have a shayukh. In other words, these people here were with our shayukh and those people there are with their shayukh. And all of them are Salafi. He says, all of this is from the creed of shaytan. All of this is from the plot and the plan of shaytan. So let your word be one word, the Shaykh says. And let your shayukh are one in the East and in the West. So whoever wants to return to this shaykh, or to that shaykh, then there is no problem. So like that, there is no issue, there is no problem. If he's Salafi, and he wants to return to the shaykh in this particular country, or that particular country, in the East and the West, and all from the ulama of al-Sunnah, then there is no problem with that. So as for those like the Asim, those who cling stubbornly to one group from them, then this is evil. And I warn you away from it, for it is from the paths of the people of desires. Beware, I say beware of falling into what is weak to you, from falling into dividing upon the scholars. There is no difference between the scholars of Ahl-Sunnah, whether they are from the Arabs or the non-Arabs. And the Salafis all over the world, inshallah, are on one page and one path. They are one. So be like this, brothers. Stay away from every affair that disunites you, like this one that we're here. And I fear that there is one who is in the middle of you, or there is a group of people, or like this, who are in the middle of you, who are plotting and planning, taking Salafiyya, so they can take a group of you this way, and a group of you that way, dividing your ranks. So whoever wants to progress this, warn from them, warn against them. And I advise you to unity of those and of rank, so Allah will raise by you the banner of the Sunnah, and with differing, it lowers the banner of the Sunnah, the banner. So fear Allah in yourself and in this dawah, and respect the Ahlul Hadith in every time and in every place. And that was the end of that particular answer to that particular. And he said at the end of Sydney, and every time and every place, and there's no differing evidence. Now. And then he asked the Sheikh about Al-Maghrawi. Al-Maghrawi in Morocco, because many of the people, they want to go there and they want to study with him. And the Sheikh said, it is upon Al-Maghrawi to return to the Haqq. He must return to the truth. He must make rujur. He must make return to the Haqq. And I don't advise anyone to go there and sit with him until he returns to the truth. And not to take from him one word, or not one kalima. And he says, for certainly what he has written in some of his books is sufficient to show us of his straying and deviating. And we have called him to repent and come back. And he has promised, or given time, and said, I'll do it, and I'll do it, I'll do it. But as of to yet, to this day of ours, he has not returned. So we're advising the people to stay away from him until he returns. But if he returns, then this is different. As we would hope for all the people to return back to that which is correct. But we're advising the people not to take from him and not to go there. And then I asked the Sheikh about a Sheikh in Egypt, Abdul Alim al-Badawi. And there was some the Sheikh had thought it was another man by the name of Muhammad al-Badawi, something like this, Abdul Alim. And he said that, he asked me, was he Takfiri? He said, Takfiri. And I said, well, Sheikh, I don't know that of him. We don't know that of him. Perhaps it's another person. He said, then I don't know who you're talking about. He said, but verily this within itself says something. So certainly most of the people that we don't know there, that we don't know anything about them, we don't have any connection with them, that in most cases are with the Hijri. He said, because we know the people of the Ahl al-Sunnah, they're in Egypt. They have a connection with us, and we have a connection with them. And then we asked him about the going to Jordan and sitting with Ibrahim Shakra, Abu Malik. And the Shaykh says, until he returns to the truth, until he repents and returns to the truth, then we would advise the people to go there, but not as of now. And then I said to the Sheikh, Sheikh has the points that we have put together against Abu Muslimah here in America. Did they reach you? And the Sheikh said yes. And then I said to the Sheikh, I said, Sheikh, well, what do you say about these points? Because verily we had people who still try to defend him, and they tried to lie on our Sheikh, Sheikh Muqbil Hafidahullah Ta'ala, and saying that the Sheikh had given him tazkiyah. And I mentioned, yeah, Sheikh, we know that the Sheikh did not give him tazkiyah. But we want to say, what do we say about these individuals, because they're trying to make this statement. And then the Sheikh said, I say to you, that even if the Sheikh had given him tazkiyah, and even if Sheikh al-Albani had given him tazkiyah, and even Ahmed came back, and even Yahya came praising him, he said, verily the praise will not precede the criticism that is in him. Verily the praise will not precede the criticism that is found in him. So verily we gave that individual, Abu Muslim, a few things that he had to do, or some things that he had to do. He had to retract those statements that he had made, and repent and come back from those evil statements, and also he had to make the affairs clear, his salafiyah clear, where he was in opposition to the people of innovation, wherever they are, and in unity with the people of salafiyah, wherever they are. But rather, he never did this. So what he did was write down his aqeed and minhaj, and really what he did was write it from the aqeed and minhaj of Abu al-Hasan al-Ma'aridi, hafidah Allah Ta'ala. So the Sheikh went on to say that until this individual makes his salafiyah clear, a clear salafiyah, that all the people can see that he is away from the people of Hizbiyah, and in refutation of them, he is with the people of salafiyah, and the wala wal bara, then until then we're saying that he is upon that, and we're advising the people not to speak with him or to benefit from him, or like this. And then the last question that we had asked the Sheikh, Hafidah Allah Ta'ala, was about Pakistan and the going there, or in India. We were wondering about who was there from the people so the people could benefit. And the Sheikh had mentioned something of the people. He said he wasn't really aware because it's been some time and he's been there and what have you. And he did need to know who was there in the past. And Sheikh Wadiyah bin Sindi, Hakibah Allah Ta'ala, Ali Rahimah Allah Ta'ala. And like this, but right now he doesn't really know. And that's basically what the Sheikh had brought. حسبه الله تعالى وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.